Hi, and welcome to Castanet's Week in Review. I'm Nich Johansen with your top stories from this week. All eyes were on the province's north this week when the RCMP took action to enforce a court order, clearing the Wet'suwet'en First Nations blockade that was preventing access to a pipeline project. On Monday, police arrested 14 people on the unceded Wet'suwet'en territory while clearing the service road for Coastal GasLink pipeline workers. The move sparked protests of solidarity with the First Nation group across the nation, including in Vernon and Penticton. On Thursday, the Wet'suwet'en hereditary chiefs reached a tentative deal with the RCMP. It's been a particularly bad flu season this year in the interior, and several young people have even died from flu-related complications. This is due in part to the dominant strain this year being H1N1, which is known to impact younger people more so than the elderly. Even so, 5 times the number of children under 10 have been hospitalized from the flu this season, compared to 2015-16, the last season H1N1 was the dominant strain. Interior Health is encouraging people to get their flu shots. After several short extensions, Kelowna's In from the Cold homeless shelter will be closing up on January 21st. The shelter, located on Sutherland Avenue near Gordon Drive, provides beds for 45 people. Staff have been frantically looking for a new location since September, but they've had no luck. A person was sentenced in Kelowna court Friday to 14 months in jail for sexually touching a child 9 times over a 10-month period from 2015 to 2016. Jeremy Carlson, a transgender person who has since transitioned to a woman and legally changed her name to Riley, pleaded guilty in November 2017. The case garnered national attention when Carlson's defense applied to have the judge remove herself from the case after she shed a tear while listening to the victim's impact statement. But Justice Monica McParland ultimately stayed on the case. A Penticton man is asking the city to do something about urban deer after his 2 dogs were attacked in his backyard last Sunday.
And there's 3 deer in the backyard. I chased them away, then I got the dogs inside to check if they were injured, and this one's eye was covered with blood. So I took her inside and said my heart broke when I saw her eye.
Myers credits Dr. Oz at the Rose Valley Veterinary Hospital with saving his pet after the attack. That's it for this week's Week in Review. For Castanet News, I'm Nich Johansen.